The topic is pastries. So there are different ingredients which are basically used in pastry making, and the ingredient gives the proper combination and the proper proportion of the ingredient gives the proper texture, proper flavor, proper color of the pastries. The ingredients which are basically used in pastry making are flour, fat, liquid, sugar, eggs, yeast, and spices and additives. First one, flour. So flour gives the proper texture, proper structure of the product. In case of pastry making, flour requires a longer fermentation period and also requires a high tolerance power also. Okay, that's because of, in case of pastry, we need a longer bench work, or in Danish and puff pastry, we need more rolls and more folds. So that's why flour, which are basically used in pastry making, needs a longer fermentation period and also need a high tolerance power. Okay, second ingredient is fat. So once lard were used in pastry making, but nowadays it is banned for the health issues and also the religious issues. Okay, so now butters have the proper richness and the proper flavor, but the problem is that butters melt very quickly in the room temperature and spreads here and there. Okay, so a pastry maker use butter and margarine, the blend of a butter and margarine, for balancing the proper flavor and the proper texture also. Second, next ingredient is sugar. Okay, sugar gives the proper flavor, sweet flavor, proper crisp, and also gives the proper color of the crust. At the time of baking, sugar converted to the caramelized, and caramelized gives the proper color. Okay, next ingredients which is used in pastry making are liquids. Liquids help for binding the product. The liquids which are used in pastry making are water and milk. Okay, next ingredient is egg. Egg gives the proper bind, proper flavor, uses as a shortening agent, and also gives a proper richness. Yeast, we all know yeast helps for the fermentation, and after the fermentation the dough converted in the double in size. Okay, and last ingredients which are used is additives and the spices. Okay, the spices and the additives which are used in pastry making are cinnamon powder, vanilla essence, lemon zest, lemon rind, etc. Okay, so those are the ingredients which are basically used in pastry making. The next, the classification of the pastry. Okay, pastries are classified into four categories: short crust pastry, chew pastry, hot water pastry, and puff pastry. Short crust pastry are also divided into two: rubbing method and creaming method. And puff pastry also divided into four: flaky pastry, full puff pastry, rough puff pastry, and Danish pastry. Okay. So this is the classification of the pastry, and the topic is puff pastry. So in case of puff pastry, at first we have to make a base dough with the flour, salt, fat, and liquid, and keep aside for the 30 minutes. After that, we have to cream the fat and keep aside. Next, after the 30 minutes, we have to roll the dough into the rectangular shape, and the thickness should be 1/2 inch. Okay. Next, we have to divide the fat into the three different portions. After that, we have to apply one portion of the fat into the rectangular dough, okay, just leaving 1 inch margin around the dough. After that, we have to fold both the ends of the rectangular dough to the center and shut it like a book fold, and the thickness of the book fold look like this. After that, we have to repeat this rolling and folding with the fat. We have to repeat this rolling and folding with the other two portion of the fat at two times. Next, we have to repeat this folding without fat one time. Next, bake it and make a puff pastry. Okay, this is the making process of the puff pastry. And what are the classification of the puff pastry? Well, not the full puff pastry, flaky pastry, rough puff pastry and Danish pastry. So in case of full puff pastry, the proportion of the fat and flour is 1:1. Okay, in this case, we have to fold this pastry, we have to fold this dough with fat with 3 times and without fat 1 time. Okay, in case of flaky pastry, we have to fold this dough. In case of flaky pastry, the proportion of the fat and flour is 3:4, and we have to fold this dough with fat 1 times and without fat 4 times. In case of rough puff pastry, the proportion of the fat and flour is 3:4, and we have to fold this dough without any fat, okay, 4 times. And the last one is Danish pastry. Okay, so in case of Danish pastry, the proportion of the fat and flour is 1:2, and we have to fold this pastry just 1 time with fat. Okay, we have to fold this pastry just 1 time with fat. Okay, so it's all about the puff pastry. So this is the classification of the pastry, and the topic is hot water pastry. So in case of hot water pastry, the proportion of the fat, water and flour is 1:1:3. Okay, and the process is, at first we have to heat the water and the fat together and make a mixture. After that, we have to add the mixture with the flour and knead it immediately and make a soft dough. Okay. So after that, bake it and converted it to the pastry. Okay, so that is the method of making hot water pastry. Classification of the pastry, and the topic is choux pastry. Okay, so in case of choux pastry, the proportion of the fat, flour and water is 1:1:2. And the process is, at first we have to boil the fat with the water. This is the burner. Okay, we have to boil the fat with the water. Next, we have to slow down the burner and add the flour gradually and cook it in the slow flame. Okay, next, after the cooking, we have to stop the burner and add the eggs gradually in it and until it's converted into the dropping consistency. After that, we have to put the mixture in a piping bag and put it in a baking pan and bake it immediately. So this is the process of making choux pastry. This is classification of pastry, and the topic is short crust pastry. So short crust pastry are divided into two categories: rubbing method and creaming method. In case of rubbing method, the proportion of the fat and flour 1:2. Okay, the flour basically used weak flour just because of it absorbs less water. Next, the fat which are basically used is refrigerated fat. Okay, so at first we have to put the fat and flour together and rub it properly until it converted to the breadcrumb like texture. Okay, and make sure that every particle of the flour coated with the fat. Next, we have to make a mixture of salt, water and sugar, and we have to add it with the flour and knead it with our fingertips, okay, until it's converted to a smooth plastic paste like texture. So that is Robin method. Next is creaming method. In case of creaming method, the proportion of the sugar, fat and flour is 1:2:3. We have to, at first we have to cream the fat, sugar and the egg together. Next, flour is then folded in and kneaded lightly to the form a soft dough. Okay, so that is creaming method.